हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, जय हिंद, गुड मॉर्निंग, वेलकम बैक। एज यू ऑल नो, इन चैप्टर नंबर 14 स्टैटिस्टिक्स वी हैव ऑलरेडी इन लास्ट लेक्चर नंबर 3 कंप्लीटेड द टॉपिक ऑफ मोड ऑफ द डेटा। नाउ इन टुडेस लेक्चर we are targeting to find one another measure of central tendency. As you all know, there are 3 measures of central tendency: mean, median and mode. We have already explained mean and mode of the data, how to find it. In last lecture number 3, we discussed about mode of the data. Now in today's lecture, we are targeting to understand median of the data. In today's lecture number 4, okay dear student, chapter 14, statistics. Statistics, and in today's lecture we are targeting the topic of how to find median of the data. Symbolically, you must have studied in 9th standard, the symbol of the median is capital M. Today what we are going to target in this particular topic, dear student, you have in 10th standard, you have to understand how to find median of only group data and classified data. You have already understood in 9th standard how to find median of ungroup data. I think you may be remembering the formula also. What we are going to do today, that today I will, even as a revision, will take some example of ungroup data, and then we will continue finding the mean of group data as well as group classified data. Okay, so first in revision, dear student, we are targeting today ungroup data. This might be a revision for you, but I am taking this topic. The purpose is in your material at the back, in objective section, there are so many examples, one-liner and MCQ, which involves utilization of formula of median for ungroup data. So we have to take it. Okay, suppose dear student, we take one example. I write some observations here. I am not going in that detail of what is median, because faculty might have explained that median means, you all know, centrally located observation. When you arrange the observation either in ascending order or descending order. Okay dear student, now suppose I give you some observations, okay, and we are looking for finding the mean of that. This way the observations are written. Okay, if I am asked to find the mean of this, so what we are doing, at first you will write all observation in ascending order or descending, whatever you like. Suppose I have written all observations in ascending order. After I write all observations in ascending order, What I have to do, I have to count number of observations which can be designated by n. N equal to 5 observation. Because it is odd number of observations, you must be remembering the formula, dear student. Because number of observations are odd, this is the formula you have to target. Median means n plus 1 upon 2th observation. I am just writing the abbreviated form of observation, OBS. N plus 1 upon 2th observation. Orally, dear student, if you can substitute value here, 5, 5 plus 1, 6 upon 2, that is third observation. Find the value of third observation from the ascending order of observation. This is 12. So this is your answer. This is how median can be calculated quite easily when you have been given ungrouped data and consisting of odd number of observation. This is the formula you should target. Suppose, dear student, I give one more example, okay? Suppose we take example like this 22, 20, okay, 18, 24, 14, and 26. Suppose you are given observation this way. So what you will do first? First you will write all observations either in ascending order or descending order. You understood? Okay. Let me write in ascending order. First 14, then 18, then 20, then 22, 24, and 26. After writing all observations in ascending order, I have to find how many number of observations are there? 6. That means we have even number of observations now. The formula for the median. Some part I will do here and some I will continue here for the board, limit of the board. M equal to whenever odd number of observation, even number of observation, this is the formula. N upon 2th observation, N upon 2 plus 1th observation. And we have to take the average of that, so upon 2. Okay, I may continue the next part here. Just concentrate, dear student. I am continuing here. So equal to, if you substitute the value 6 upon 2, so that means you can understand third observation plus 6 upon 2, 3, 3 plus 1, that is 4th observation upon 2, okay. Let me substitute the value from this observation arranged in ascending order. 3rd observation value is 20. You can verify in your book also. 4th observation value 22 upon 2. 20 plus 22, that is 42 upon 2, turns out to be 21. This is a revision of 9th standard as you have studied in statistic chapter how to find median of ungrouped data. This is the way you can find median of ungrouped data depending on the sign, depending on the number of observation. If they are odd, the formula is median equal to n plus 1 upon 2th observation. If the number of observations are even, formula is m equal to n upon 2th observation plus n upon 2 plus 1th observation upon 2, to be taken the average of that. So this is the formula, okay? Now, dear student, this is a revision and I have to take it, understand, so that this formula is applicable while you solve some MCQ, understand? So we have to take a revision of this. This is, we have taken the revision of median of ungrouped data. Now let us target, dear student, median of grouped data. Okay, now our target is this, median of grouped data. In that also, dear student, when you are targeting median of grouped data, you have to be very, very conscious. There also the method is no doubt little different. When we solve example, you will come to know that the method is drastically different from what you have studied in finding median of ungrouped data. Understand, one another factor is going to be added here. Suppose, dear student, let us take example number one, okay? We are targeting to find median of grouped data, okay? Suppose the example, let me write xi. Suppose I give xi 2, just write with me 2, 7, 3, 2, 7, 3, 1, 9, okay? Then I am given the column of frequency. Please note down with me. Frequencies are given 7, okay, then 10, then 4, then 11, and then 3. Now, dear student, try to understand. We are given two columns, one of xi, one of fi. How to find median of such ungrouped data? One factor you have to add here in frequency, okay? This is new column you have to make of CF. What is meaning of CF, dear student? CF means cumulative frequency. This might be a new word for you. In old textbook, they were taking the symbol capital F as cumulative frequency, but in your textbook, they are taking symbol CF. What is actually the meaning of CF? Meaning of CF is quite simpler. CF means cumulative frequency. Name itself gives you an idea. Cumulative means constantly increasing frequency. That is called cumulative frequency. How can you find cumulative frequency? So just go on adding frequency, you will be able to prepare the column of cumulative frequency. First frequency 7, so CF will also be 7. Now, dear student, try to cumulate it by adding in the next frequency, in subsequent frequency. 7 plus 10, please note down with me, 17. 17 plus 4, 21 plus 11, okay? 7 plus 17 plus 4, 21 plus 11, that is going to be 32. 32 plus 2, 35, okay? How to find CF? Is it clear in your mind? First frequency to be represented as first cumulative frequency, and then just go on adding in the subsequent frequency. 7 plus 10, 17 plus 4, 21 plus 11, 32 plus 3, 35. Now, dear student, mark one very important thing. Your last cumulative frequency, this one, your last cumulative frequency is always the total of the frequency, because that is found out by cumulation only. So directly you can write here n equal to 35. This two needs to tally, okay? Now, dear student, as n equal to 35, that is odd number of observation, formula of median, as you all know, n plus 1, because odd number of observations, n plus 1 upon 2th observation. If I substitute 35 here, 35 plus 1, 36 upon 2, that is 18th observation. Now, dear student, how to read the value of 18th observation? Now please concentrate. See, dear student, if you get 18th observation, nowhere in CF column you are getting this value. How to analyze the given tabular data now? Concentrate. How will you analyze the data? See, dear student, now your concentration should not be on frequency. Your concentration needs to be entirely on first and last column. First CF is 7. What it suggests, that if you arrange all observation in order, the first 7 observation is value 2. Try to understand, dear student. First 7 observation has value 2. Now, after 7, if you start counting from 8 to 17, try to understand this. 8 to 17 observation has value 7. Then means 8 to 7 observation, try to understand, dear student. I am writing here 8 to 16. That means what? First 7 observation has value 2. 8 to 16 has value 7. 17th already given. And this way you try to understand data. 17 to 21. So what should I say? From 18 to 20, observation has value 3. You understood this? 21st observation, undoubtedly the value 3. That means what you collected from the data, dear student. First 7 observation has value 2. 8 to 17, I must say, has value 17. 18 to 21 has value 3. 22 to 32 has value 1. 32 to 35 has value 9. Our observation lies in this range from 18 to 21, I must say. So what is the value of observation 3? This is very important to understand and analyze also, looking simple but little difficult to understand. First seven observation is value 2. Means if you write observation 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, that way. Then 8 to 17 observation is value 7. 18 to 21 is value 3. This way you try to analyze data. 21 to 32 is value 1. 33 to 35 has value 9. This way you need to analyze the given data and you can find observations. Okay, dear student, is it clear in your mind? Right. Can we do one thing? One more example, because I haven't included such type of example so far in our material. You understood this. So let us do one thing. Can we have one more example? I will write here as an SLP, okay, self-learning practice, which you have to solve immediately in your book, okay. Let me write one example here, okay, which you will solve. Please note down with me and you solve, okay. That is instantaneous SLP for you. Number 2. Let me write the data here. 10, okay, 7, 9, 5, 14. Frequency I am mentioning here, okay, 3, then 11, then 15, 3, 11, 15, 6, 3 plus 14 plus 29 plus 6, 35. Okay, and 8. Okay, dear student, try to solve this example by yourself. Okay, just do it. 29, 35, 40. Okay, just do it by yourself in a short span of time. Okay, then I will definitely solve the same example here, giving you 5 minutes time to solve this. Because every student may not have the sharpness to understand, it will take time, so I am giving a little more time. Just try to verify this, how we have solved the previous example. This is the similar one, okay. You just have to find cumulative frequency, and after finding that, the formula I have intentionally given the number of observation as odd observation to strengthen your topic, okay. Make it fast. Make the column of cumulative frequency, total the number of observation, then after number of observation, decide the formula to be utilized, and that way you try to solve this particular example, okay. Try to solve this. By the time we will have some more examples where also we will look for finding the median of the data, but I will change the number of observation. Okay. Just try to understand this. Okay. Clear in your mind. I am just doing it here. You just verify those students. First cumulative frequency is 3. Then cumulate it by adding in subsequent frequency. 3 plus 11, that is 14. 14 plus 15, that is 29. Plus 6, that is 35. Plus 8, 43. Last cumulative frequency, always give the total of the frequency, that is 43. Then you must have written this way, number of observation are 43, that means odd number of observation. Even though, dear student, we know, who don't know that 43 is odd number of observation, but you need to write, okay? M equal to S, you all know. N plus 1 upon 2th observation. Just substituted value, substituted 43 plus 1, 44 upon 2. That means 22nd observation, where you must have looked. Value of first 3 observation 10. 4 to 14 has value 7. 15 to 29 has value 9. And our observation lies in this range. So your answer must be 9. This is the way you can solve such example. Many students must have solved. What you need to do is that you just have to verify with your answer, understand? This is the way CF is to be found out. Just verify. Those students who could not solve, please verify this one. Just verify it. Those who are able to solve, they just need to check their method and just need to check whether their analysis is matching with my analysis or not. Okay? So this is the way we have done example to find median of ungrouped data. Where precisely I have taken one example and one I have given in instantaneous SLP, precisely targeting number of observation to be taken as odd. Now we are targeting ungrouped data, but I am changing the number of observation to be even, okay? Let me write the example. Example number 3. We are already given value of xi. Please note down with me 18, okay, 22, 38. Okay, 30, 35. Okay, then you just take 39, 42. Okay, 39, 42, 45 and 47. Okay, these are x values of xi, 18, 22, 30, 35, 39, 42, 45, 47. Let us write the frequency. 4, 5, 8, 8. 4, 5, 8, 8. Okay, then 16, 4, 1, 2, 3, okay. Let us first calculate this particular example. CF, dear student, first CF will be from F itself. Go on adding subsequently 4 plus 5, that's 9. 9 plus 8, that is 17. Okay, 17 plus 8, that is 25. 25 plus 16, that is 41. 41 plus 4, that is 45. 45 plus 2, 47 plus 3, 50. Okay. Last cumulative frequency always give you the total of the frequency. So m equal to n equal to 50 observations we already got. Now dear student, n equal to, I will continue the sum there, not here, okay, or some part of the sum. Let us take at least formula. N equal to 50, that means even, okay. Now dear student, you know the formula, that of one group data we will apply here. N upon tooth observation plus N upon 2 plus 1th observation, and we have to take the average of that, that means upon 2. Okay, even number of observation means the change in the formula. N upon 2th observation plus N upon 2 plus 1th observation upon 2. Now dear student, I am continuing the example here. N upon 2, 50 upon 2, that means 25th observation plus 50 upon 2, 25 plus 1, that is 26th observation. 25th observation plus 26th observation upon 2, because we have to take the average of that. Now dear student, need to understand how to read the given data. Okay, you know all very well because we have done in previous one. How will you read it? First, 4 observation as value 18, 5 to 9 has value 22, 10 to 17 has value 30, 18 to 25 has value 35, 26 to 41 has value 39, 42 to 45 has value 42, 46 to 47 has value 45, 48 to 50 has value 47. We are looking for 125th observation and another 26th observation. We are looking for that. So dear student, just target 25th observation. See here, 25th observation, this one has value 35. 26 lies here, this range. You understood this? Please concentrate. 26 to 41 all has value 39. You understood this? So 25th observation has value 35. 26th observation has value 39 upon 2, dear student. 9 plus 4, understand 14, 1 carry, 74 upon 2, this is to be divided and answer is 37, okay? Just try to understand. Here what is more, in one such example I will definitely give in SLP or in homework, whatever. But try to verify. This is very, very important for you to understand the given data, how to read the data, and how to substitute the value. That is very, very important for you. You understood this. First, FI, we found CF. Always this fact to be remembered by you. Last cumulative frequency is always giving the total of the frequency. Formula for the even. N upon 2th OBS plus N upon 2 plus 1th OBS upon 2. Then we have orally substituted the value 50 upon 2, 25th observation. Here should not make any mistake. I told you initially also, 25 upon 2 or 50 upon 2, 25 plus 1th observation upon 2. 25th observation directly available, 26. 26 to 41 as value 39, that we have substituted. And this is the way you can find the median of ungrouped data which has even number of observations. Need to understand. In group data you may come across these two facts. Understand, sometimes the number of observation may be odd, sometimes the number of observation may be even. At that time, dear student, a change in the formula, and then it is just a question of reading the data properly without any mistake. Is it clear in your mind? Just verify this. Okay? So, in today's lecture, dear student, we have targeted median of the data. Median means centrally located observation, where two examples I have taken as a revision of 9th standard already, which you have studied in 9th standard. That was the revision of that, how to find the median of ungrouped data. That was a revision, okay? Then we took median of group data. We are not taking in today's lecture the median of classified group data. That we will take in our next lecture. But in today's homework, dear student, what is the homework for today's lecture? This is the homework, okay? What you need to do is that first, note down your homework. All examples which we have done, dear student, all example ones. Whatever example we have done in the lecture, to be done once again by you. And one more example I am giving. I am writing it here. Please note down with me immediately. 12, 13, 14, note down quickly, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19 and 20, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, frequency 7, please be quick, 10, 15, 18, note down quickly, 20, then 10, 9, 8 and 3, quickly note down this. All example which we have done already in our lecture, to be done once again to strengthen the topic of how to find median of ungrouped data and grouped data. So all example we have done to be done once, and this is one more example which you have to solve in homework. Okay, dear student. So this way, in today's lecture, we have targeted the topic of median, and we have today done median of ungrouped data, okay, and median of grouped data, where the number of observations were sometime even and sometime odd with minor alteration in formula, and developing the skill to read the data, we have done it. Okay, dear student. So in today's lecture, till here, median of classified data and rest of the example we will target in our next lecture. Okay, thank you very much.